Pacific shellfish employs a specific type of trapping that we call control or suppression trapping. And really the goal of that style is to remove green crabs at a scale where you might start to see a reduction of their population size, as well as a reduction of their spread and potential impacts.
Our typical day is to drive the boat up to the traps, collect them as fast as we can. We want to make sure that we get the green crab, identify them, bag them up, and then dump the bycatch. So if it happens to be Dungeness or red rock crab, we get them back in the water because they're native species. For us, it's really critical to see that connection of the oysters being part of that three-dimensional habitat. And when we saw the invasive green crab in that area that we know is important for Dungeness, and the value of those crab and that habitat to the ecosystem and then also to the rural economy, it became apparent that it was going to become a significant issue.
Shellfish, Dungeness crab, shrimp. These animals are all prey items of European green crab, but also European green crab will compete with Dungeness crab for resources like space in places like oyster beds, and that's where Pacific shellfish is catching their European green crabs. Same habitats can also serve as Dungeness crab nurseries, so the threat can be even more amplified for a company that focuses on these multiple species, because the green crabs sort of threaten all of these resources in various ways.
We've partnered with WDFW, collaborated with Sea Grant, other people who are interested in trapping green crab out with us to see. It definitely has been a collaborative process.